Welcome back to The Edge. If Google Marketing Live could be summed up in just one word, what do you think it would be? The GSC performance reports are currently delayed about 65 hours right now. What will Google search look like in 10 years? Who knows? We've got a lot of AI news, a lot of AI tools today, and a Barry Blast for News from The Edge for this week of May 29th, 2023, here on Edge of the Web Radio.
From the Edge of the Web studios, here's what we're looking at this week.
That was kind of tough to get out there. Too much in the intro. There's too many things to talk about. There's so much news. And AI is making more.
AI. I would sing more, but I have a cold.
That's Morty Oberstein. Morty, how you doing, sir?
I have a cold, I said.
Very good. Yeah, I wasn't listening, really. This is Aaron Sparks. I'm the host of Edge of the Web. Thanks for joining us. We tackle the digital marketing news each and every week, and more it's turning into AI news. So who knows? We can just split off the entire podcast.
What do you mean more and more? You're the one putting it on the news doc. If you put other stuff there, there'll be other stuff there.
It just shows up. AI is actually writing into the spreadsheet that we keep all the news in, so... That's happening. Jacob Mann, Creative Studio Producers on the Stick. How you doing, sir?
I'm doing well.
Excellent. Excellent.
Did you get a new title? Creative Studio Producer?
Director.
I don't know.
Director?
We're having AI write his titles every show.
We get a new title every show now.
What would you ask it? OpenAI.com.
I should give ChatGPT my title and say, give me 10 alternative titles. And just rotate through them.
That'll be awesome. If you're new to the show, we cover digital marketing news of the week, separate from our interview series that we do each and every week, talking to some fantastic guests from around the planet, talking about digital marketing tactics that you can use for enhancing your digital marketing work week. Check out everything over at edgeofthewebradio.com. That's edgeofthewebradio.com. The title sponsor of Edge this week is Site Strategics. We're proud to have the title sponsorship of this show. Very proud of our team here at Site. We are one of the top SEOs in the country here, and we're cranking on entity SEO each and every day. It's fantastic to be able to dig in and be able to see what Google's paying attention to now. The reason for the show, actually, is what we do here each and every week. We learn and be able to bring into our team to benefit our clients. So if you're interested in what we do, just go check us out over at sitestrategics.com. Like I said, Morty Oberstein, head of SEO branding, joins us. It's about a bit over his second year with us as co-host.
And is it really?
It really is. It's surreal. It truly is.
Wow.
I know.
That's a long time.
It's an on time. It really is. But that's we value
LinkedIn
it.
Profile.
What's that again?
I should add that to my LinkedIn profile.
You got it on Twitter. You got it on Twitter. But yeah.
I try to bring visibility to the show.
I appreciate that. I appreciate that greatly. And every once in a while, he's doing the tweets before we are on our own show. So that's
I'm up earlier, 7 hours ahead, so I can tweet before you ever get to it.
He is in the future. How was today, by the way?
Yeah.
That's terrible. We might as well quit now.
God damn it. What are we looking at
about tomorrow? Tomorrow?
It's also going to suck.
We were talking to Brody Clark. I goes, hey, you're in tomorrow. How was that? Don't come here. It's not good. Stay where you are.
These are like bonkers in Australia, right? Like, I don't follow the news at all about these things, but someone was telling me that Australia is bonkers.
I just know they have kangaroos.
They got kangaroos. That's about it, huh?
And they fight.
Let's see. Australian news. Man pries crocodile jaws off his head at Australian resort. Oh, man, that's bonkers.
Is that like Florida, man?
I don't know. Australian volcano near Antarctica captured on satellite spewing lava.
So what I'm hearing here is we need to split
giant
our new show
reptiles
into...
reptiles revealed to have sword Australia sky...
This is a new segment.
I literally just typed in Australian news, dude.
So we're talking about having an AI news show, but maybe an Australian news show as well.
There you go. See? And we're just going to diversify ourselves. A little franchises everywhere.
Giant lizard spewing lava, prying them off my head.
That is an AI generative right there. All right, hey, we've tried to pack in a lot of news into this show here, and the more and more wanting to bring around some AI information, we'll try to get through as much as we can. But Google's always at the top of our list as things are happening. Google Marketing Live 2023 came through from Search Engine Land by Greg Finn, friend of the show. He wrote about everything that you need to know from Google Marketing Live 2023. The core component of this year's Google Marketing Live event can be summed up in just two letters, not even one word. That's AI. So
is AI not a word yet?
No, it's not.
Okay.
Just that.
Is that a word?
I think it is. As much as we're using it, it's going to be a word.
It's going to turn into a verb pretty soon here. Mm-hmm. So a number of AI changes on the marketing platform Google Ads lets you create campaigns using conversational AI. You can now create Google Ads campaigns with Google AI-driven chat directly with the Google Ads interface. That's a new asset. They also have Google Search Generative Experience integrating with search and shopping ads. We're talking about SGE here a little bit later on the show. But in the demo, in the lab's demo, all ads were located outside the conversational chat. Now that's changing. Google's now working directly and integrating ads into the SGE experience. Google PMax adds generative AI to create text assets and images. So that newest campaign type will actually soon be offering even more automated experiences with Google's AI baked into the campaign setup process. Google Ads will create AI-powered assets that target search queries. There's so much that this thing is doing now, and we're going to have our hands off the handle or off the wheel very, very soon. Google's Product Studio brings AI-generated images to advertisers. Merchant Service, there's one thing. Merchant Center is now Merchant Center Next. It'll soon replace the original Merchant Center, and it's going to be much more simplified for product feeds that they can actually leverage on your website. It's going to be able to pick up a heck of a lot of data from your site without even interacting with it. And on top of that, 7 new Google Ads features, including brand restrictions in broad match AI in smart bidding. Whew. There's a slew of things that they announced at Google I/O, but more importantly, Google Marketing Live. Slew of stuff, and they got a panel that they're actually going to be talking about all of this. Quick promotion at SMX Advanced. So it's going to be Julie Fried-Bakini, Gil Gidner, Melissa Liu, as well as Greg Finn. So it's going to be a good panel of experts tackling all of this. How many times can we say AI Finn in the Finn, show, man? Huh?
How did Freddie Finn get on that panel? That's nice.
Oh, he's not there. Oh my gosh, he's not there. Let's rally for him.
Gentlemen, I have breaking news.
Should be.
An acronym is a word formed by the first letters of each of the words in the phrase or name. So AI is a word.
That is a breaking news story, huh?
I'm glad I could be here for that.
All right, okay. Well, check out all that information. And again, hopefully Greg can get on the panel. That would be fantastic. Sorry, I misread that. I included him in because he should be right there.
You know, yeah, he damn well should be. Let's advocate for...
Yes, let's have a groundswell.
You know what SMX said? No, not by the hair, my Finny Fin Fin. I've used that joke before on him.
I'm glad you did, as opposed to doing it first on this show. Probably would have had to edit that one out. All right. Second article over at Search Engine Land by the Barry Swartz. Google Search Console performance report is delayed, but Google will fix the issue, and most likely is fixed by the time you listen to the show. But have to pay attention to what's going on there on the performance report.
I don't know. Reports. It's been hours. It might not be.
Typically, these reports are updated within 4 hours, but this thing has been 65 hours delayed.
Yeah.
That's a pretty significant delay.
That's a long time. That's like days. We're not talking hours anymore. That's days.
Yeah, it crossed that line very, very quickly, didn't it?
It's like, oh, it's only been a few hours. How long? 65. All of the news people must be losing their minds.
They probably
can't
are.
Track nothing.
All right, well, pay attention to that. And we hate to see bugs in the Google Search Console performance report because we steer by that. And especially if you're pushing out a huge amount of content on a regular basis, that you're blind to the world there. However, you know what?
I just want to take a moment and say, these things do happen.
Yeah, they do.
No platform is perfect. Let's remember that.
And they make changes regularly, so it could very well be that they were making a change. Something got held up here. You'll get your data back. Trust us, right? Hopefully.
Yeah, and if your data sucks, you're like, hey, this is great.
All right, well, you know what? You know, whose data doesn't suck? It's Site Strategics, as we work on our clients on a regular basis. We're a 19-year-old digital marketing agency, one of the top in the region here. Our core specialties are technical SEO, entity SEO, conversion rate optimization, focus on results-based marketing that works. So if you're interested in what we do here, as well as what we do on the show, because we also build podcasts on a regular basis. As
you
well.
Do.
We do.
And we know.
I know. There's one special
you know
one out there.
Know?
Right? How do you know?
SERPs up over at wix.com/SEO/learn/podcast. SERPs.
I give them the softball every time, don't I?
Is produced by Edge of the Web Media, Inc. Studios. LTD.
Every time. It's a different company. We have no idea who's actually producing it.
I work for as many companies as I have titles.
We're like changing like the Borg, right? check out Serps Up. It's a good show. And I mean, Crystal Carter's doing a bang up job over there.
She is. Can't disagree with you. Like The Rug and Lebowski. It really ties the room together. She really ties the whole podcast together.
Nice. Good reference. Deep cut there. Yep. All right. For Search Engine Land by Danny Goodwin. Google search of today won't exist in 10 years, says DeepMind co-founder Mustafa Soliman, co-founder of DeepMind, which Google bought in 2014. He says Google will look much different in 2033, where conversation is the interface rather than the search box. Before going deeper, what do you think about that statement right there, Morty?
I mean, like, that's kind of obvious in a certain sense. Like, it's not going to be the same in 10 years from now. It's like saying, you know, cars.
Exactly.
Are not going to be the same in 10 years. Bold prediction. Cars will not be the same in 50 years from now.
Well, think about search 10 years ago, right? We still had 10 blue links, and it hasn't really changed.
Well, yeah. No, like, I understand what he's saying. Like, it's going to fundamentally change because of SGE and the way users are interacting with content and what they expect out of content and all that good stuff. I would agree with that. I think it's necessarily a bad thing.
Sure.
But search has fundamentally changed, I think.
And, I mean, just the key concepts of how Google understands content. And we've been rolling towards this particular event horizon for a very long time. And we've been talking about a lot of changes. And MUM was being discussed 16 months ago or something like that. And, yeah, things are coming to a conversion point. We're going to see a heck of a lot. I keep on going back to that time machine cut that we had where the guy was walking through H.G. Wells. He's walking through the time machine and he was flipping through an archive and it was all immersive. It was, the thing was singing to him at some point in time. And it was exactly what was being described as this chat interface, multimodal environment. We're going to see that come to a screen near you very soon, right? Right. All right, so.
Yes, I'm sorry. Cold got my tongue.
No apologies there. So, I mean, ChatGPT, we're seeing a lot right now, especially SGE that's just rolling out. We're all grabbing a hold and having a look at the experiments right now and seeing what's coming up.
I can't get access.
Oh, my gosh. I got
access.
Can
you? Do you have access?
Yeah. I've got access
right
now.
It's a country thing. I don't think even the UK people have it. I think it's just the US. No, because Alita has it. So, but I've seen.
He's probably VPN'd in. Do you know how to VPN?
I have like a different kind of VPN for security purposes. I don't have like that kind of VPN.
It's the other kind of VPN.
I'm not cool.
Speaking of SGE, all right. So jumping into our AI news, Google opens access to Search Generative Experience, except to Morty. Some of you who actually sign into the wait list will get an email notifying you that you have access to try this out. So what is that SGE? It's Search Generative Experience. Rolled it out on May 25th. Google said today we're starting to open up access to Search Labs, a new program to access early experiments from Google. They wrote, if you're already signed up for the wait list at labs.google.com/search, you'll be notified by email when you can start testing the Labs experience. It's actually very, very cool. There's a lot of SEOs that are screenshotting and doing a lot of video presentation there and some interesting exclamations and a lot of citations that we thought were going to be there that aren't in some of the demos that people are showing. I don't have anything in front of me right now to actually talk about, but Maria Haynes is out there, Marie Haynes, Lily Ray, Glenn Gabe's out there, and evidently Morty doesn't have access to it.
I don't have access. So.
I'm so sorry. So the AI-powered search experience is going to be coming to all of Google very, very soon. And it's going to be the immersive environment, what we talked about on the show, but also this kind of choose-your-own-journey space where you're going to get a heck of a lot more information on the subject matter you're looking for. But honestly, the 10 blue links experience is going to be going away, and we're going to have a heck of a lot more visibility of images and video content. And on top of that, Google's digging deep into video content with, there's another story that didn't make the cut about YouTube and how it's actually doing another level of transcription. I got to track that down and put it in the show notes. But anyway.
Wait a minute. The story doesn't make the cut. Are you allowed to mention it? Morty and I are on the same page here.
What's that?
You have all these links, all these stories, and then now you're bringing up ones that didn't make the cut.
Yeah, exactly. So we're going
to try to make us look bad. Like, not make the cut. Comment because we didn't see the story. He could be making the whole thing up, and I'm like, oh, that's really interesting, huh?
That's the play here, right now, right? I was asking ChatGPT to help me with the show today, so who knows if the thing's actually accurate or not.
Big improvement, I'd say.
I pulled an article that was 2 years old.
Yeah. I'm like, is that a purpose?
Wow. I missed that.
I was pulling in some AI news. I got Feedly working on AI now. And it's like, oh, hey, look at that. Oh, Morty posted
it.
Wait
a second.
Wait a minute.
You're not like curating any of this stuff? You're just taking your Feedly and pulling it into the doc?
I've got everything. I got spreadsheets.
I'm going to create a Feedly and pull it into the doc and see how it goes. Yankees news. Harrison Bader's got a hamstring problem.
All right. Hey, well, there is news. Quick headlines. New superbug killing antibiotic discovered using AI. Completely out of left field as a marketing environment here. But all right. So AI helped narrow down.
I need some AI to help with the title. You're saying that there's a new.
There's a superbug killing antibiotic.
Killing antibiotics.
It's a superbug.
Or the
hyphens matter.
Antibiotic killing superbugs.
A new superbug killing antibiotic.
That doesn't clarify things for me.
Antibiotic that kills superbugs.
Right.
This is why Google rewrites titles, you guys.
Yeah.
This is a headline, this is like, too. This is terrible.
This is like, that was a dangling modifier, whatever it's called. Like, yep. You can go, I, like, it could.
Was this written by AI? I wonder if this article is written by AI.
Oh,
that
no.
would be wonderful. Nope.
No, because then it'd say discovered by me.
So now it's actually going after superbugs. It's helped narrowing down thousands of potential chemicals to a handful that could be tested in the laboratory. The result was potent experimental antibiotic called abucin, which will...
That's not a real name.
Abucin. Abucin. Otherwise known as Skynet.
Where does this article come from?
The BBC.
Oh, that explains it.
All right, I just wanted to throw that one in there because that was exceptionally weird, but, you know, AI is AI.
No, it kind of like, you know, to be honest with you, I kind of feel like AI is built to do those kind of things versus,
absolutely.
Like, I don't know, write your entire website for you without any modification.
Absolutely. I mean, AI is going to be used for stargazing and being able to find more and more constellations and be able to see different types of planetary objects out there.
That's
so
useful.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely.
Look, we found 5 new stars. Things are so different now. I'm sorry, the killjoy.
Wow, talk about a super bug killer. I mean, that was terrible.
Well, you can really notice it. Look up at the sky; you really notice. It looks very different.
It's useful information, right? Anyway, here's what also is useful information: Meta's open source speech AI models support over 1,100 languages. This is coming out of AI News. Advancements in machine learning and speech recognition technology have made some sizable jumps here, and Meta-led Massively Multilingual Speech, MMS for short, their project has made remarkable strides in expanding language coverage and improving the performance of speech recognition and synthesis models in 1,100 languages. Combining self-supervised learning techniques with a diverse data set of religious readings, the MMS project has achieved impressive results in growing the well over 1,000 languages supported by existing speech recognition models. Now, here's the deal. This was a self-supervised learning technique. Is this meaning that AI is actually teaching itself, right? Self-supervised?
That sounds like it. Sometimes I let my kids self-supervise. That doesn't go well.
No, it's not.
You know what I think this means?
What's that?
Our hreflang files are going to be 2 megabytes in size.
Absolutely.
You can pick all 1,100 languages.
I'll be honest with you. I don't think there's any like use for hreflang for, like, I don't know, ancient Aramaic.
Hey, that is not cool for you to leave them out.
It's not cool.
Like, you got to have every language.
Oh, I'm speaking ancient Hittite.
Yeah. Is Pig Latin one of the languages?
I've got my Babylonian.
No,
page.
It's not one of these. It's trained on ancient biblical languages.
It is.
That's why I don't think there are 11,000 actual spoken languages used today.
It was 1,100, but
whatever it
right.
is.
Right.
Well, I'm fact checking for the show.
So it's like ancient Babylonian. Great.
It's just trying to figure
you know
out
what's more
how
useful
to speak
than
with
that?
Us.
The five stars they found.
The five.
Breaking news.
Wow, here we go.
7,100 languages are spoken in the world today. I had no idea.
No way.
That's what the Google search says.
Wow. I thought it was like the low hundreds.
I would have totally gone. I would have agreed with you on that.
Wow.
I'm clearly ignorant.
So really what this article should highlight is the fact that we're nowhere close to having all the languages covered. Got to try harder, AI.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, there's 7,100 languages, and meanwhile, they're focusing on like the 1,100 that are completely out of date, that haven't been used in 3,000 years. Right.
That's the building blocks.
Yeah, it's foundational, foundational concept. It's trying to learn all possible permutations. And then it's going to actually teach us a brand new language. It's going to be the Tower of Babel AI. How about that?
Babel AI. We can't do it.
Well, there's always Babelfish, too.
Right.
Yeah, from Hitchhikers.
Yeah.
All right. How many rabbit holes can you go down? 1,100 rabbit holes right there?
Yeah.
All right. A little bit of public service announcement. AI scams target older Americans, a growing concern over at Medium, multiplatform.ai. Members of Congress are actually concerned about AI scams targeting older Americans. The bipartisan group of senators wrote a letter to the FTC requesting information on how AI technology is influencing scams and impacting older Americans. Voice cloning technology is being used by scammers to replicate individual voices and deceive victims. Specific examples are cited, including a scammer pretending to be a grandson in need of bail money and another posting as a kidnapper demanding ransom. Didn't we talk about this? About somebody spoofing somebody? Oh, that's right. That's right. It was somebody who was about to give away $600,000. What was that? Oh, my gosh. It was crazy.
I mean, a couple of stories.
Yeah. Senators are actually expecting a response from the FTC June 20th. Here's the deal. Why I threw this one in here is that we're about to go into election season. We're already there. We're going to see a lot of AI spoofing going on. There's going to be, I mean, we've already reported on the story that we're just not ready for this type of thing. And they're going to be attacking and going and trying to scamming the elderly as well, because that's going to be the target.
It's easy.
It's going to be very easy.
Always, it's like terrible. Like, but you know, like using the AI to kill antibiotics, like that. Well, not to kill antibiotics.
Yeah, killing the bugs. Killing
kill the bugs.
Stay up with a story here.
That's what AI should be doing.
Right.
Not scamming a grandmother.
I'm glad you set the parameters there.
That's the bar.
Yep.
Is really high and really low at the same time.
My grandmother once told me that she got a phone call from a male voice. She said, "Hi, Grandma." And she said, "Oh, Jacob." And that person responded, "Yes." Mm. And then like one or two sentences in, she's like, "This doesn't sound right." So she asked this person a specific question and they just hung up on her.
Yeah.
But if that was attached to AI, and if the person did minimal research to figure out my social media profiles and let AI listen in and respond in questions, like, "Oh, tell me who you're married to." It just pops up an answer.
Yep.
I mean, you don't even need voice changing some of the times.
Can I bring up the pink elephant in the room?
What's that?
Your grandmother seems to have done a minimal research on what your voice sounds like.
No. Like, she just, that's not what I'm saying. I'm saying that like right away, it didn't sound or feel right to her, which is why she prompted with a question.
She doesn't know your voice?
I don't know what this voice was. Maybe it was just close enough.
The story I was talking about, I was talking to a friend of mine on Friday. You know, he was talking about a $600,000 scam where he was actually persuaded by somebody who was posing as a friend of his, and it was a full mimic of this individual, and he let go of like $125,000. And then, and only then, after additional interactions, did he say, "Okay, I'm just going to contact this guy." And he actually contacted the guy and found out that this was a full-on scam before he actually released another $400,000. Wouldn't you have actually checked? I mean, come on.
But that's just
it. You would think.
You would think, but sometimes you're just, I think your adrenaline hits and you're trying to help someone. And right. I think they work on those numbers. If we send this to 10,000 people, one is going to bite and send us something.
And it costs them literally nothing to do.
Nothing.
Yeah.
I mean, this has really been a problem for a long time, though. Like I bet you Arnold Schwarzenegger's been like worried that like maybe Bill Hader's going to call up Maria Shriver and be like, "Hey, how about we get back together?"
He was holding on to that for like 15 minutes. You know that?
Wait, he's going to imitate who? Bill Hader does.
Bill Hader does like a great Arnold Schwarzenegger impersonation. Like, what's the?
Twice.
Oh, very good.
Twice. Oh gosh, killing me, Smalls. All right, we always want to lock and load with a couple of quick AI tools that are not used for scamming. Oh, you might want to look at this.
When you say we always like to, this is literally the first time we're doing this.
I did last week, but you weren't there, so hey.
Okay, fine. I wasn't here. Sorry.
Zip chat.
Always to Aaron means 2 weeks. Like, I've always loved you.
Tomorrow I'm going to hate you. All right. Zip chat, an AI chatbot powered by GPT-4 for e-commerce business that resolves 50% of your support questions instantly. That's an interesting. It's a 5-minute setup, chatbot preview, and you can train AI for more personalized and accurate answers. Nothing could go wrong here, right, folks? It's trusted by a lot of e-commerce owners. You can go check it out. No promotion here. It was just something interesting that we came across here. Another one that was even more interesting. Check this out. It's called Logic Loop. All right? You can ask your data any questions. So it's over at logicloop.com. You can set up alerts and automations on top of your data, and you can literally query your data conversationally. Remember all the SQL statements that you've been trying to build over the years, right? You can literally start interacting conversationally with your data. Just saying that is kind of creepy, to be honest with you. Any thoughts there, guys? No? Nothing?
I want to know if the tool that replies back to your customers can reply back. Can you train it to reply back in the tone of Arnold Schwarzenegger?
It's a good question. Right? I'm not doing it. I'm not doing it.
Don't do it again. Third time, then we're gonna have a discussion. I thought that would be interesting, is looking at an entire SQL statement being built by conversational. That's the type of tool that we should have with AI. All right, you know another tool that we should have that's not AI, well, it's partially AI. It's InLinks as sponsor of this show. Do you know that entities play a major role in how search engines understand and rank content? We've talked about this ad infinitum. Obviously, content solely around keywords is the thing of the past. So check out InLinks as a great award-winning software in entity SEO. If you go over to edgeofthewebradio.com/InLinks, InLinks, you can actually take advantage of some really cool AI technology and natural language processing to be able to actually cross-link and be able to dynamically associate pillar content as well as create some fantastic content briefs using AI knowledge or AI processing. So edgeofthewebradio.com/InLinks today. And let them know that, well, by going there, you're letting them know that you heard them on our show. Got a couple fast tracks to wrap up the Barry Blast and wrap up the show. Hold on a second. There's two shots of Morty in that.
Wait, because he got pictures. Jacob asked me for pictures.
I may have asked Morty for some extra pictures.
I see. So it is new.
Yeah.
Wow. I just want to say, I asked ChatGPT to reply back to a customer, like Arnold Schwarzenegger would, using quotes from his movies, telling the customer that they're wrong.
I love it.
I'll be back.
As you may recall, one of my legendary performances, I said it's not a tumor. Similarly, I broadly proclaim it's not a fault. And then, like, it goes through, like, all these quotes. Like, in conclusion, where is it? Now, to address your claim directly, I must quote another one of my famous lines. Consider this a divorce. Let us sever the bond of disagreement and move forward. And then it signs off, wishing you resilience, understanding, Arnold Schwarzenegger.
There you go.
It signed off, Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Oh, my gosh. This is getting crazy.
That's awesome.
It's terrible.
It's the best.
That's why I'm throwing AI, because, I mean, literally, it's everywhere. And might as well herd it into little cats and give it to you guys. All right. Last couple of Barry Blasts here.
Barry Blast.
Google announces new topic authority system to better surface news content. Google said that this will actually help newsy queries in specialized topic areas such as health, politics, and finance. They actually announced a search system named Topic Authority to help surface relevant, expert, and knowledgeable content in Google Search and Google News. Google said this helps determine which expert sources are helpful to someone's newsy query in certain specialized topic areas such as health, politics, and finance. Barry
in
says
other
that,
news, old,
exactly,
not new.
Everybody pounced on that. That old, thing's been new. Around for the longest time, right?
Yep. I think Barry even updated at least the SEO Roundtable story saying, like, turns out this is old.
But for those who are playing at home, yes, you need to continually build your authority in the marketplace so you can actually be a topical authority expert, right?
Yes.
All right.
It's official.
It is official. You know what's also official? Last bit of news here. Google has done its last mobile-first indexing switch this past weekend, a 6-year process. I called Morty Barry. Channel your inner Barry there.
That is so flattering. Also insulting to Barry is anything.
All right, Barry, tell me, what's going on here? So what is mobile-first indexing for our listeners, and why is it over?
First off, it's anticlimactic, no?
It really is, yeah.
after all this time, finally finished. So yep. Google's looking primarily at your websites through its mobile bot and indexing the content through its mobile bot. So the mobile version of your page that's being indexed, which there impacts what is ranking or what theoretically could rank. Because if your desktop page has one thing and your mobile page is another thing, you might be shocked that you're not ranking because your mobile page is different than your desktop page, that sort of thing.
So we also know that if you're not responsive, right, at all, that you only have a desktop version of your website, you will not be seen in mobile search at all. It's going to be on desktop search,
well,
right?
Well, theoretically, because not every website in the world is on the mobile first index. Like, there's still a desktop crawler.
Okay.
Like, I think what I don't want to take words and put them into John's mouth or sure. Barry's mouth, but like, you know, if you're not moved over now, like, it's never going to happen, basically. So.
Now, I remember 6 years ago, that was mobile getting, right? That was longer than that, actually. And mobile first indexing came through a little while later. So if you're not responsive, what the heck are you doing here? But pay attention to that. Go over to Search Engine Roundtable. Check out all the stories that Perry does on a regular basis. Hey, there's another story that happens each and every week, almost every week. That's hashtag SEO chat on Twitter. What's going on over there this Thursday at 1 p.m.?
Jacob, bring it up. There we go. Sarah McDowell, who you might know from the SEO Mindset podcast over at Captivate, because she works at Captivate. So check out a little pitch for Captivate. There she is hosting SEO chat this Thursday at 1 p.m. Eastern Standard Time over on Twitter. And this time we're talking about the importance of being an LGBTQ plus ally in marketing and SEO. Look for it on Twitter at 1 p.m. Eastern Standard Time on Twitter. I'm doing a terrible job with my radio voice because I have a terrible cold for like the third week in a row. But that's what it is.
I don't know. Alita Solis says that you could be a radio announcer if this whole SEO.
I wasn't sick then. She did. She did say that.
I know because we're editing your show right now, but
that's right. That comes out on Wednesday.
It does. Wednesday. It does. Interesting enough, is Sarah McDowell is actually going to be recording here in about a half an hour. We're going to be talking to her about a lot of cool things regarding the SEO mindset, not only the podcast, but actually what you know, the well-being of an SEO in today's marketplace. So that's pretty cool.
Yeah.
So again, we're not going to ascribe to you as the perfect SEO mindset, but you're
No, I'm far from the perfect SEO mindset.
But Barry is.
Barry's perfect in all ways.
All right. Hey, final things for our listener today before they completely give up on us.
I don't think anymore. I just have AI do it for me.
The background has changed. I think he is like Morty Hedrum. I think that's what's going on there.
Oh, nice. I mean, like, now that AI is signing off with people's actual names.
Yeah, that's a little bit of an overreach.
Yeah.
That's a little, yeah.
All right. Well, that's it for The Edge. Thank you so much, Morty. Appreciate your participation. And we'll try to contain the IA. The AI. See? It's got to be a word now. I'm reversing the order. All right. Check it out. We're going to be posting the show notes for all the news articles and much more over at edgeofthewebradio.com. Check out Martha Van Berkel's second segment of our show this week. Some fantastic discussions about schema, structured data, and your own knowledge graph. So dive into that. Make sure that you like, comment, and comment over to our YouTube channel. And if you like what you heard, maybe at the tail end of this show, but if you like what you heard, give us a rating over at ratethispodcast.com/edge today. And that will help us get in front of the others that haven't heard us yet. And maybe you want to abuse them. So give us a positive ranking if you would. From all of us over at Edge, stay safe, stay well, and do not be a piece of cyber driftwood. We will talk to you later. Not search.